Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video, and today we're gonna talk about adaptive sampling. I know that a lot of people don't know how to use it and even don't know what adaptive sampling is. So let's talk about it. So let's get started. Adaptive sampling, in a few words, determine how much noise you're gonna have in your image. And in more words, actually, adaptive sampling is a rendering option that disables sampling for pixels that reach a specified noise threshold. Okay, so let's take a look on how to turn on and turn off adaptive sampling. You have to go to the render properties and scroll down to adaptive sampling. So we have to turn this option on, and that's it. Very easy, right? Here we have the noise threshold. So this number here is where you're gonna tell Octane that Octane need to stop. So for example, if you put here, in my case, I have 0.025. So it means that when Octane reach this amount, it will stop rendering. Okay, so here we have the minimal adaptive samples. So this number means that when Octane start rendering your image, it won't turn on adaptive sampling until Octane reaches this amount, that is 256. So it means that doesn't matter the number you put here, it won't count. Okay, so for example, if I use 500 here, and here in my max samples, I'm using 1000. It means that for the first 500 samples of this 1000 here, Octane render won't turn on adaptive sampling. After that, the rest of the other 500 samples missing, Octane render will turn on adaptive sampling, and then we use this amount here. Okay, so let's take a look on the render, how it works. So to do that, I'm using in the preview pass, the noise pass here. So if you go here and choose noise pass, then you have like the same pass I'm using on my left side here. Okay, so we are gonna be switching to combine and noise to see the results. Okay, so let's take a look on the combine. So this is the image. Okay, so we can see that we have a lot of noise here, but this noise pass actually tell us how much noise it has. Okay guys, so let's take a look on this render here. And what we have here is gray areas. And you're gonna see that after a while, some green areas pop up. And this gray area means that the Octane render is still rendering all these gray areas. Okay, so when these green areas here pops up, it means that the Octane render has already reached this noise threshold here. So it means that Octane render is not rendering these green areas anymore. So Octane render stop and focus on the rest of the image that's not green yet. Okay, so let's see what happened if I increase this number here, the noise threshold, to something higher. So let's see 0.05, for example. You're gonna see that on my render, you get green very fast. Let me stop this render. And it means that the Octane render has already reached this amount because it's very high, and probably we are going to have a lot of noise in this image, and it actually Octane render will stop rendering after reach this green areas, this amount of noise threshold. So you're gonna see that the samples here will render very fast, like faster actually than lower amounts. So let's take a look on like how much time it will take. So let me start the rendering again. Actually, let me press F12 so we can see here. So you can see here, we have a red like reached 100, but this number will increase very fast from now on. 200, 500, and probably, yeah, that's it. So it took 32 minutes to render this image, and we are going to have a lot of noise because our noise threshold is very high. Okay, so if you decrease this number here to 0.01, for example, and press F12 again, let's take a look on like how much time it should take. So it took 1 minute and 20 seconds to render this image, and probably we are going to have much less noise than the first image because the noise threshold here is much lower than the first image. Okay, so we still probably have some noise in this image, and to get rid of this noise we have to increase our max samples over here. Okay, so how can I calibrate my noise in my image, right? So that probably is one of the questions you are asking yourself right now. So how much samples I have to put here, and how much samples, noise threshold I have to put here. So probably is, I think this is the main question about this tutorial, right? Okay, so let's take a look on the noise pass again. So I'll change it to the noise pass here and let's render it. Okay, so let's say that, actually let's take a look on this image and let's see which area here takes longer to render. So this will be our parameter to know where I'm going to focus my adaptive sampling. Okay, so let's wait a little bit just to see the green areas. Probably I'll increase a little bit this number here. Oops, too much. 0.02. Okay. And I will stop the render. So we know that these green areas here are the faster part of this render. So we know, we understand that these green areas will render faster than the other areas. Even if I increase or decrease this number, this part is the faster part in this render. So you have to identify in your image what are the faster parts using this noise threshold here, increasing and decreasing, or trying to balance this number just to like try to see it quickly, these green and gray areas. Okay. And I think the main thing is to identify where is the slow areas. That is, for example, in this case, is here, okay? So knowing that, what we are going to do is make a region here, a crop render, and use this crop render as the parameter. Okay, if you press Ctrl B in your viewport, it's the shortcut for the region area, the crop area. Okay, so just drag and release, and that's it. It means this red area here means that this part is the only part that you will be rendering right now. Okay, so you can see it here that everything is faster, the sample is rendering very fast. So it means that only this area here is rendering. Okay, so one thing that you have to have in mind is how much noise you want. That's important. How much noise you want in your scene. Okay, so let's say that you don't want too much noise in your scene and your value of noise threshold is 0.01. That's a really good number, and probably you will have actually slow renders because 0.01 it will refine your image, your noise very well. Okay, so this is a good number if you want to achieve low levels of noise. Okay, so but the problem is to understand how much samples you need to get rid of this noise, right? And here is where this trick comes in. Okay, so let's put something higher just to have a fast result. So let's put, I don't know, maybe 3 here. And let's say that we're going to use 2,000 samples for this exercise. So I will restart the rendering and I'll stop it right now. Okay, so oops, let me restart it again, sorry. Stop. Okay, so now we got this fully green area and we reached the amount of 6,000 samples. So it means that to render this entire image with fully green areas, you have to use 6,000 samples. Okay, so let's take a look on the entire image and make this test here. I'll increase the number here to 6,000 and let's render it again. Okay, we have 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, almost there, 5,000, and 6,000. So as we can see here, this is the example. I think this example is like perfect example. So you can see that using that technique with the region, you can have faster renders to determine how many samples you need to achieve a certain amount of noise. Okay, so that's a really good example. I increased this number because actually it would be faster, okay? But as I said, the lower values you use here, actually you get slow renders, but you have low amount of noise, okay? So very low amount of noise using low values here, okay? But your render increase Certainly. Okay, so that's it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed it, and please, if you like it, subscribe to my channel and leave your like as well. And thank you very much. See you in the next video.